coming out of it, representing Cork, Ireland.
It's a fight to stay busy. It's a fight for bigger, better things. And that's what O'Sullivan talked about yesterday.
He said, I have a Mexican style just like the
Lumpkin. And you have a Mexican support tonight. You ready to fight September 16 on the Mexican Independence Day against possibly Canelo?
Mike O'Sullivan is in Las Vegas to fight on the undercard of one of the most anticipated fights of the decade.
Big win tomorrow night and everything changes. His whole life changes.
It's been the biggest fight of his career, and I do predict if Spike's in the right frame of mind, a win within sight of distance.
Basically down to, you know, who's got the biggest balls here.
There's many more.
And that's going to come down to that.
This former sheet metal worker is only 10 rounds away from becoming a boxing Hall of Famer and a multi-millionaire. Every year, tens of thousands of prize fighters dream of hitting the big time. They believe it's their destiny to become champion of the world. In reality, most will earn less than a few hundred a fight. Most will be on minimum wage. Most will never own their own home. Fighters know this, yet every day they still find the courage, the will, and the self-belief to put their lives on the line.
I'm afraid of the next fight, the one coming up, you know. I'm not afraid of the opponent, I'm never afraid of the opponent, you know. I'm never afraid of anybody, it's just the fear of losing, you know. Getting to start training, I suppose I was about five. My father started holding the pads and had me punching pads. And I remember going to Parky Cueve, my dad and my brothers as well, to watch Steve Collins against Eubank, and wished that was me. You know, one day I thought I'd love if I was that man. I don't know if I ever thought I was actually going to get there.
The iconic Celtic Warrior gym in Dublin's working-class estate of Corduff is run by Spike's coach, manager, and closest confidant, Packy Collins. Loved by the locals and adored by the boxers, Packy is the brother of Celtic Warrior superstar, Steve Collins.
Me and Pascal, I suppose, like, we're like brothers, you know. You know, he wants what's best for me, and sometimes he doesn't think I'm doing what's best for me, so he gets frustrated with me, and he annoys me, and I annoy him, and we kind of argue at times, kind of, you know. It's like a relationship with your brothers, you know. We love each other, and we want what's best, you know.
I was brought up to help people, you know, to bring out the best in people, and I love it. These people that chase the money and go after the money, you know, off you go, open the door, let them go. But the people that stay and they enjoy what I enjoy, the journey, they're the people I want around me. When we started out together, we're like fight by fight basis, you know, keep them winning. Try and find the perfect style for Spike. he was a puncher from the start, and he had a nice style, but it was all over the place, and we set ourselves a goal, let's maybe get you an Irish title fight in 2 years. Which worked, he won.
He became Irish middleweight champion, and then the opportunities arose at middleweight, and I was kind of seen as a middleweight. I got a rank in a middleweight.
What makes a champion is the drive and the willingness to do whatever it is you have to do, even though you're hurting other people around you. To be so driven, to be so selfish, that's what makes a champion.
He's known me since I'm a child, you know, since day one. I grew up across the street from him. We lived in the same neighbourhood. Both our families are very close relationships.
I was actually at Spike's christening, and his family were very good to us. In 1991, my own son, he died of meningitis. And I said, look, if I ever make it in the tree business, I'll support you from day one. And that's what happened. But I'm so proud of him. It's just, he's like a son to me.
At this stage of the game, it's about providing for my family, and there's a lot of stake in these fights, and losing can set you back significantly. Like, you know, my missus is keeping us, you know, afloat all this time whilst I've had no finances, basically, and got these beautiful kids and my missus that drive me on to provide for them, you know, so that's my biggest motivation. And
Spike has never been knocked out, never been knocked down, but he has known defeat twice.
He put in a right old shift to Sullivan, but it just simply wasn't anywhere near good enough.
Well, while we were away, Spike O'Sullivan retired in his corner. Gets the stoppage. Tough defeat for those proud Irishmen to take.
You lose, you know it's ahead. You know you have to go down a few rungs on the ladder, and so you have to come back, and it's not an easy thing to do.
Matched against a stronger, faster bookies favourite, Spike was supposed to be just another notch in the belt of the young rising star, Antoine Douglas. But Spike cut alcohol, changed his diet, and stunned the boxing world.
By knockout victory, Spike O'Sullivan.
And somebody was watching, somebody who could alter a man's destiny, somebody by the name of boxing legend Oscar De La Hoya. De La Hoya and president of Golden Boy Promotions, Eric Gomez, had a crazy hunch that this working-class white boy from Ireland might just ignite the imagination of the most passionate fight fans in America, the Mexicans. As the rest of the boxing world was still absorbing Spike's savage win over Antoine Douglas, Packy Collins was in talks with Oscar De La Hoya and Eric Gomez. Packy secured an astonishing 3-fight deal that would culminate in Spike fighting for the unified championship of the world.
LA then set us up for this 3-fight deal. We've been handed a new opportunity for Spike, and it's huge.
With a beautiful wife Intercontinental Middleweight Champion, the fighting pride of Cork, Ireland, Gary Spiker Sullivan.
You from Cork, Gary?
Yep.
That's where my family's from. Back in like 1800s, but no, I've never been. I'm going in September.
I'll come meet you. Bring your own somewhere.
There you go.
Be the champion of the world, giving you a tour of Cork.
Yeah. Can't beat that.
And you won't be able to beat it. You have to pay me good.
With only half an hour to go before the official weigh-in, in front of the world's media, Spike is a pound overweight.
Thanks, and you look great. So elegant.
I think you look like more of a Mexican than a Canelo Alvarez.
And it features both Rio Piedras,
'Stop. I want you to freeze. Allow me to come in and separate you guys, okay? When I say break, keep your hands up. Protect yourself at all times. When I say box, you can engage again, okay? There'll be times when you guys are maybe in a clinch. I'll say work out of that. That is not a break. When I say work out of that, you can punch, okay? Okay. Now, the fight's going on. You guys are engaged. Boom, you land a good shot. Your opponent goes down. I'm going to say down. When I say down, please, don't hit a down fighter, okay? It's necessary, it's mandatory that I give 8 seconds. That's mandatory 8 count. If he gets up at 2, I still got to go to 8. What I don't want to do is send a fighter back out to take punishment that is not necessary. So at 8, I'll be evaluating the fighter. Now, should you get knocked down, I want you to know what I expect out of you, okay? Just like what we got here, good, strong, solid eye contact. I may ask you if you want to continue. If I ask you if you want to continue, I expect you to move your head so that everybody knows that you were okay, okay? Because if you're not okay, I can't send you back out there to take punishment that is not necessary, okay? Now, he's your fighter. You know him better than
absolutely.
I do.
Absolutely.
Okay?
Yep.
If you see him in trouble and he's not responding the way you think that he should respond, I want you to get this gentleman's attention.
Yes.
Okay?
Yep.
And then we'll protect him, okay?
Absolutely, yeah.
Have fun,
thanks,
all right?
Thanks very much. Thank you.
Have fun.
Thank you.
Right.
When Spike walked out wearing a tailor-made green sombrero, the crowd went wild. Oscar De La Hoya and Eric Gomez's crazy hunch had been correct. Before he had thrown a single punch, the crowd made this Irishman an honorary Mexican. Now, all he had to do was win.
He's had 11 knockouts before. You know, if he knocked me out, my dreams of having a magnificent house that I want for my children, you know, and my partner, for myself kind of as well, but not so much myself, my kids more. But, you know, that'd be all fucking gone. Gone with the one punch. You know, so I was nervous that could happen.
You know? Here to see you, Spike.
Who's that?
Yeah, thanks for coming to see me.
No problem.
I wish you the best of luck.
Yeah, they're boxing humbles everybody. You know, it's a sport at the end of the day, like, so you've got to be a sportsman, you know.
It's wonderful, though, all the messages, you know, and I see one time, there's a great fighter, Sergio Martinez. He said, one time after his fight, he'd like 6,000 messages, something like that. But when he lost, he had like fucking, I don't know, a few missed calls from his mother or something like that, and no one else. Fucked up, isn't it?
The next night, Spike and Packy watched Golovkin defend his world title from the stands. Spike believed he could have taken the champion that night. Every fighter does.
Let's go, stop chickening out. The fight to be is you versus me. Lemieux versus Sullivan. Lemieux versus Sullivan. So let's do it.
Spike and David Lemieux was a different type of fight because you're going to be on there, you're going to be getting hit by him, you're going to be hitting him. But we still believe Spike would beat him and then set up a fight with Canelo to fight the winner.
Tweets with me are a joke. The tweets are a bit of banter. Generally, there's no personal hate for me. It's business, like, at the end of the day. But Lemieux, I think he's insulting towards his opponent.
Does Ty look alright, is it? It's lovely. Come on, let's go.
It seems like there's a lot of war words right now. Is this a personal fight for you? Has it become a personal fight?
Yeah, it's always business to me in the end of the day, but...
Do you throw some shots now on the social media against Lemieux? You say, hey, I'm here in the lobby, come on, downstairs.
He didn't show up, did he?
Spike wasn't a fan of David Lemieux. Lemieux made comments about Spike, and Spike made comments about David Lemieux. At the end of the day, make all the comments you want in life and all the... you know, the tweets you want, like, but you still have to both step into the ring together and fight each other. So there has to be a respect there between both fighters.
Look,
here he is,
here
is fucking bitch.
David Lemieux. Hey, look.
Here is a bitch on Saturday, bitch.
You see what we have? Hey, well, this is the moment. David Lemieux, a champ from Canada. So, you're ready to go. You throw some punches against the social media, so we're going to talk with you later, but here we are with the guys ready to go, right? It's going to be a great fight. David Lemieux. Okay, well, Gary also, oh my God, what a hit.
I think that, I mean, that was the first time they've seen each other since they've got to Vegas. And I think it became very real for David Lemieux, and he realized he's in an awfully tough fight.
Saturday night, we're gonna fight. The talking will be done. What is that? Smell that? I think I smell fear.
I'm retired.
I can sense fear in him, you know. I genuinely can sense the fear in him. He said for this fight, he said he's going to try to hurt me permanently.
Oh my God, he's been through a really, really dark time in his life. You know the old saying, what does kill you makes you stronger. He's mentally strong, especially down to, you know, who's got the biggest balls here. And that's going to come down to that.
Oh, that's a great life. We'll end it right there.
Big win tomorrow night and everything changes. His whole life changes.
I just see a total different, you know, air of confidence, and the training level has been, you know, in the last two fights, taken up notches, you know.
He's in a good place because he's prepared really well. His sparring was top grade. Everything is done. You know, he's in a position where he can win this fight tonight.
Too good?
It's a roller coaster of emotions, man, you know, but the best roller coaster you could be on, you know, especially when you care about the fighter, you know. I mean, this isn't a business to me. It's more about the people, and he's good people, so. I'm nervous. I started off this trying to say I wasn't nervous.
This is the biggest fight of his career. This is his moment. He wins this. It's a new league for him, you know. He makes some good money and he gets his shot at the winner, Canelo and Golovkin. I mean, you know, it'll be a dream come true. He just has to pull it off tonight.
Thank you.
I didn't see that one coming, you know, it didn't even come into my peripheral vision, it just, he looped it right around the side and I didn't see it coming, I was focused on hitting him.
I didn't see that shot coming myself, he was hurt, and David Lemieux hit so hard that it could have been probably career ending too. I straight away turned to my corner and said, give me the towel. Spike was up on his feet. That proved something to him. That was something I wouldn't have interrupted, but that's something in Spike's psyche that he actually got up off the floor. He beat the count. And the fighter to not get counted out is like huge.
He beat me, you know, so I gotta show respect and, you know, it's a sport at the end of the day, like, so you gotta be a sportsman, you know.
You're gonna win some, you're gonna lose some.
Oh, lovely.
Thank you. now, in the moment, you got knocked out. You got up. It's over. It's gone. It can't be changed. We cannot do anything with that moment. What we can do is now is build. And we had a great conversation going to the hospital, me and Spike. I said, you know, Spike, for a long time I've been saying to you about junior middleweight, and but now, why don't we do this, Spike, I said, and let's rebuild you as a junior middleweight. Spike O'Sullivan, the junior middleweight future champion of the world. Let's do that now.
Salam,
thanks.
Salam. I'll be back.
Beautiful bastard.
Hasta la vista, Las Vegas.
I just bought a house this week. This was one of my major goals, you know, and I done that through that fight.
Fight. That in there, I done my best. It didn't work out in the night.
Beautiful, you know, it was. It was a dream. Even getting knocked out. This too shall pass, you know, and if you're feeling down or negative about anything, you know, it'll pass, you know, this year, and it will. It always does.
Not just any middleweight. Lemieux's gonna be the middleweight. Like I showed you guys what I can do against Gary O'Sullivan.
And everyone has a story to tell, you know. A lot of women that I met over the years, that always wind up telling you that their dad done something, you know. Their dad was a filmmaker, their dad was a shoemaker.
He's going to be the world champion very soon.
So I want my kids to say my dad was champion of the world. You know, I'd like them to be able to say that.
I believe if he continues going, moving forward, I believe he will be a world champion. I believe he's destined.
Go to war with the champ, trying to go back but you can't. Now it's only one king, I'm the man. Anybody wanna step to the plate, better go and get one thing straight. I don't freeze and I won't hesitate. Matter of fact, y'all were running in place, can't run from your fate. Who's gonna stop me? Who's gonna stop me? Who's gonna stop me? Who's gonna stop me?
Shocking every second like a million volts. Now we hyperactive, you don't want no static. I was born for battle, finger on the pulse. Y'all paper plastic when I go Jurassic. So far from average, running with the rappers like a slinging lion, steady moving silence. So in other words, who's gonna stop me? 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 Who's gonna stop me?
believe it's destined. I believe it's destined.
Mount Everest ain't got shit on me. Mount Everest ain't got shit on me. Cause I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world. Yeah. I burned down my house and built it up again. Tell them. I burned it down twice just for the fun of it. Tell them. So much money I don't know what to do with it. Tell them. I don't pick up my phone, ain't knowing what the time. Tell them. I got me one gun and an alibi. Tell them. So much love that the whole thing feel like a lie. Don't need nobody. I don't need nobody. I don't need nobody. I don't need nobody. I don't need nobody. Don't need nobody. Got shit on me.